Coming on your face.
Loud and clear.
Are we live already?
Yeah.
Oh shit, I can't see myself right here, that's why.
Oh.
I'm like, oh shit. There I go. See, there.
That's funny.
I didn't know you wanted to see yourself. You've been live for minutes.
Oh man.
Really?
See, I could have been picking my nose or something and shit.
I told you. B-side knew.
B-side's in cahoots with you, motherfucking shit.
On.
Oh, dude, we're having a conversation about beer.
You're the worst.
We're talking about beer. Come on, man. We're like,
worst. The on air outside is
hot. He gave you the signal.
Look alive, Packy. Look alive.
Come on, man.
Okay. So we are live. My name is Packy Chan, and this is the Packy Chan Show. We got Dre Day Old Day
in the
right here. We got DJ B-side in the back. Say what's up, B-side.
What up?
And then we got a special guest. We had another special guest, but I guess he thought it was too cool for this show. Ipkiss.
Ipkiss, really? Let's call that fool up.
Call him up. Oh, by the way, my boy El Fumigado is in the fucking house. Say what's up, Fumigado.
I'm just standing.
The guy is drunk, but there he goes.
I shouldn't be here.
Oh, shit.
But you are here. You're here.
He wasn't even supposed to be here today.
Woo! He somehow hitched a ride in B-Side's trunk. And when you open the trunk, he's like, hey, I'm here!
Yes.
Oh, shit. Yes. Fucking pull me back, though.
It was a tight squeeze.
What else? Like
butt cheeks?
Anyways. We're going to get on with the show. We were running a bit late, like we always do.
You know we do.
Hey, but I think that's like... the signature of the Packy Chan Show. We're going on live for this time, but in reality is this time.
Lies. All lies.
Just to get people on and ready and anxious for our show. Like, that, what the fuck? What the fuck? Yeah. All right. If you don't move these gummy bears, I'm going to eat them.
Just eat them all.
I'm going to eat them, all right?
Just eat one.
I'm going to put it here.
Just, all right, put whatever you have.
Put it right there. Okay. Now we're going to go with the B-Days. Are we going with the B-Days, Mr. B-Side?
Yeah, you can go with the B-Days.
Yeah, go with it.
All right, B-Days. For all you motherfuckers out there who love comedy, Cedric the Entertainer's birthday, he turned 53. He's a pretty funny motherfucker.
Cedric, I loved him as Madagascar, the little lemur.
He was the lemur?
The lemur?
Yeah, he was a little lemur.
Really?
Him and Sacha
Baron
Cohen.
Oh, the fat one!
Yeah, he was the fat
one. Oh, shit, I did not know that.
Oh yeah!
I had no idea. I learned something new today. Yeah. Shit,
he was a good lemur.
He was like, I don't think we should be doing this.
What movie had? Do you like him in Cedric? Sammy Cedric.
Cedric.
Dre. Dre.
I liked him in Kings of Comedy.
Kings of Comedy.
That's what I liked him in. I don't like him in any movies. He fucking sucked in movies. I liked him in that show, the Steve Harvey Show.
Steve Harvey Show was dope.
It was dope.
But what's that movie where he played the record like a record producer or something?
Oh, I don't remember.
The Big Easy or The Big Short or something like that.
Big Short,
movie.
Really?
I don't know. It's a movie where he plays this like this big shot record producer, rap art. You know, he's promoting all these rap artists, but he's like really a G and shit. He's like he's threatening all these PRs and radio hosts and shit to play their music. It's pretty funny. I liked him in that movie.
What movie was this? What was
I have to find out. In a bit. But we're gonna move on right now. You said Hank Azaria's birthday just passed too, right?
Yeah. Hank Azaria.
Hank, does anybody know who Hank Azaria is?
Simpsons voice?
Yes.
Yeah, yeah.
I thought he did homework, but B-Side broke it down for me. B-Side,
He does a poo. Chief Wiggum. He does Mo. He does basically all the cops, the black cop, the other cop.
That's crazy. I knew he did a lot of voices, but I didn't know he did that many.
Yeah.
Wow.
Hold on. Pretty talented dude.
Okay. Cedric the Entertainer's birthday passed. Al Pacino, Mr. Scarface's birthday was on April 25th. Ella Fitzgerald's birthday passed too. Her birthday was on the 25th.
She's awesome.
George Lopez has the same birthday as me, April 23rd.
George Lopez.
Yeah, that fool's fucking funny. Who do you think is funny, Cedric or George?
George, I would say George, but George has not been funny in I think 10 years now.
Really?
Yeah, sorry. I mean, he's still funny, like just him as a person, right? But his stand-ups have just I don't know. It's just, I think he had his run, and now it's like somebody else's turn, I guess, you know. But I was a big fan early 2000s, you know. That's when he was the shit to me. But I don't know, a lot of his comedy, it's like, you know, he has a lot of Mexican jokes, but outside of that, it's like
Who's your favorite comedian currently right now, B-Side?
Oh man, that's a huge answer.
I mean, Dave Chappelle always sits on top for me, but close second, Louis C.K. as well. And who else is really good? Well, I'll just say those two for right now. Oh, I like Hannibal Buress. That dude's funny too.
I like Jeff Dunham with the dummies.
Oh, that's the funny. Most racist shit, backwards shit ever, Pecky.
It's funny, man.
Who's that guy?
You shouldn't feel so bad. It's hilarious. Because you see his shows, it's a mixture of races, black, white,
Asian. Yeah, but he does like the most stereotypical fucking voice there is that you could think of.
That's true.
But I think it's funny. My favorite character is Walter. The old dude. Yeah, he's always talking shit about his wife. Yeah. That's my favorite one. But yeah, I like that comedian. That dude. I forgot his name. But he came out in a lot of movies, and I can't remember the movies. Fuck him, I guess.
Fuck him.
If I can't remember.
He's obviously not that good.
Yeah, if I can't remember his name and shit. Oh, Dane Cook. There you go.
Dane Cook fucking sucks. Yeah. I'm sorry.
Why?
And so does fucking Jimmy Fallon.
Oh, I don't like Jimmy Fallon.
Yeah, Jimmy Fallon.
A lot of people like Jimmy Fallon suck dick. Sorry.
No, you're not sorry. He does suck dick.
Get his wigs don't follow you.
Yeah, I mean, I like, if you're going to talk about like late night hosts, I would go Conan. Conan is one of my favorites still. So, Team Coco.
Oh, there it goes.
For show.
All right. George Lopez's birthday. Selena's birthday passed. Her birthday was on April 20th.
Selena Gomez?
No, Selena's. You know, Salinas.
Just kidding, fool.
No, you're not, fool. You don't know shit.
Fuck you. We'll see about that, Pecky Chan.
And today is Jet Li's birthday.
Really?
Was that racist? No, it wasn't racist. No, I hope it's not racist.
No, you're Chinese, right? Yeah.
I am half Asian.
Oh.
I am half Asian.
I could just do this.
So,
happy birthday. Thanks, dude. thanks.
Happy birthday to Jet Li.
What movies was Jet Li in? I forgot.
He was one with Aaliyah. I forgot Romeo Must Die.
Romeo Must Die.
He was also in Lethal Weapon, in one of the Lethal Weapon movies. I think it was 3 or 4. Remember? That's when
I remember.
Member berries. Hey, if you love member berries, say something.
Sick.
Do you know about member berries, Mr. Dre?
Yeah, from South Park. That shit was hilarious. That whole season was great.
Right?
Oh, man.
I love that season. They've been hitting at the park lately. Not lately, but they're
just
dope. Do
they get new writers or something?
Why is your mic out?
Oh.
Hello.
Oh, yeah.
All right, cool.
What'd you say?
Are we going live right now?
Yeah, we're live.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm not seeing it.
Oh, you're not on where?
On Packy.
Oh, yeah. It's fucking Packy shit. Doesn't want to fucking let me go live.
Damn.
We're live on YouTube for sure.
Fuck it. All right. We'll just post a video on Facebook and shit and have them check it out.
No, I'm still going to try it. Go ahead. Keep talking.
Is this all right? Is this why you won't play?
Who else died? Anybody die?
Aaron Moran passed away on April 22nd. And if you don't know who Aaron Moran is, then look up Happy Days because she played Joni.
Oh, yeah.
Joni and Chachi. They even had their own like spinoffs called Joni and Chachi.
So I heard Chachi.
Scott Baio.
Oh, man.
I heard that he thought that she died of like an overdose or something.
Of some drugs and shit. Yeah. And ended up, she ended up dying of cancer. What a fucking prick, dude.
That is fucked up, man.
See, so I was. Anybody. Sorry about that.
If you see Scott Baio, smack the shit out of him for me, please.
Yeah, for real.
Thank you. I took the words right out of my mouth.
Hold on. Fuck, I used to like Scott Baio because, you know, he was at Charles in Charge. And there was this one movie called Zap that I really liked as a kid, but now, fuck that puto.
Scott Baio.
You know who else I really disappointed with is Chuck Norris.
What did Chuck Norris do?
What did Norris do?
He's on all these fucking commercials talking about all this Republican bullshit and fuck Obama and all this shit.
He's a fuck racist. Obama?
Yeah, he's like he's talking. Well, he didn't like Obamacare and yeah, he's all Republican. He does commercials for like politicians, Republican politicians, and pushes right wing agenda. So, fuck that fool too.
Fuck him,
Chuck Norris or Van Damme.
No, Chuck Norris.
Chuck Norris.
Van Damme always gets his ass kicked by his own security.
he's trying to pick up on them. That's why, right?
I think so.
All right, so there's one more RIP. Miss Lucille Ball. She died today back in 1980 something. What was it? I wrote down the wrong shit. Oh, 87? Or was it 89? What was it? Because you were telling me that you remember that day.
It was No. I think you're right. It was 87.
87. There you go.
I was graduating from kindergarten. And I remember that graduation day and watching that shit on the news.
Were you guys fans of I Love Lucy?
Yeah, I love that show. I watch it every day.
I was.
I watch it to this day, whenever I get a chance.
Every time it's a rerun, I watch it.
Yeah, it was a good show.
It was an awesome show. Rest in peace, Lucille Ball. Lucy!
I'm home.
So that's the B-Days, and that's the RIPs for today's segments. Mr. B-Side.
What's up?
Can you put up some beats? I feel like freestyling a little bit.
Alright, sir.
Oh, shit.
Dre Day. I know you're live and direct. I need you to jump in with me.
Let's do this.
This is the freestyle session right now. Ha ha. Mm-hmm. Hey. Ha ha. Yeah. Hey yo. Hey yo, I'm feeling pretty good. I just smoked up this blunt. Gonna roll up another one. We're gonna have some fun. Yeah, this is the Packy Chan Show. And we coming at you live. We got Dre Day and Fumigado, that's right. We got DJ B-Side getting down in the back. Mixing it down, man. No, he ain't whack. Hey yo, we doing this because it comes to us naturally. Hey yo, where's the rest of the MCs jumping in this with me? Mr. Dre Day, all day. Ready to spray these lyrical bars. Hey, 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 I'm gonna hit this.
Yes. It's been a minute since I spit it, but I'm about to come committed. I don't give a fuck, cause yo, I forget it. Yo, cigarettes, I don't smoke it. Blunt size, do it sometimes, but I get high. Yo, this is a rhyme. I rhyme words with other words, and I come through with punctuations and commas. And yo, I'm not with that drama. I come through with phrases, and I'm laced up. But yo, sentences ain't my best thing, so let me lace it up. Let me bust flows about marijuana and weed. I used to need and I used to fiend when I was a teen. But now I'm older and it's legal and it's all gravy. And yo, I'm hoping I never have a fucking baby. I got a dope wife upstairs and that's cool. And yo, I graduated from school, but now I'm just in debt. So forget that shit, don't do it. Just get to school and fucking
spew it. these lyrics, and we're just gonna do it like this. Crazy with the shit, man. This is the cool mix. We're having a good time. We're coming at you live. Like I said, man, no, this shit ain't dead. Hip hop isn't dead either, man. It's still alive. We're thriving from all over the places, man. That's right. Hey, yo, be on the lookout for my album.
Good morning, sunshine.
Hey.
Yo.
Welcome back. Us.
And we're back.
I don't know what the fuck happened.
We had a power outage, man. We were spinning hot, that hot fire.
And that shit caused an outage and shit, man. It was like a fire reaction and shit.
There's a fire right now.
Fire
in the house and the place to be. Super Audio Brothers and Packy Chan and B Side and this ride. And I don't give a fuck. I don't know why I try. I'm not an MC, I used to be a rapper until I got shut off like the motherfucking clapper. I got a girl and I stopped being sad and I stopped being bad, so I stopped being mad. And yo, this shit's not whack, so I'ma pass it to Becky Chan so he can spit the facts.
Yeah, I'ma spit the facts, I'ma let you know how it be. Yo, this is the Super Audio team, we are the Packy Chan Show. In case you didn't know, when we're doing the freestyle, this is a little flow. Actually, it's a super duper flow, cause I won't stop at all, man. Just to let you all know, we're like a train wreck. Actually, we're causing casualties everywhere we be. I'm the MIC. Hey, yo, you don't know who I be? Look me the fuck up, go on Google, you'll see what's up. You'll find me on FB, Facebook, and Instagram, Snapchat, goddamn, no, I don't give a damn. And if you don't like that fact that I use the word God in that, then I don't give a damn about that. And I don't give a damn about you. I speak my mind, man, and yo, I spew lyrics that I feel coming at me, coming out of me, man. No one can stop me, no one can stop me. You need back the fuck up, you need back up to even try to go up against me. It ain't gonna happen, I'm just gonna keep on smacking and clapping and just attacking. Hey yes, I'm feeling good, I'm feeling fine. Hey yo, man, I'm loving these rhymes of mine. Where's the gummy bears at? It's right here.
Ha! Yeah, yay!
Is El Fumigago gonna spit a floor or what the fuck?
He doesn't spit
El
for free.
El Fumigado.
Is the mic on?
Hello?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, El Fumigado doesn't spit for free.
Oh, he pays money? You gotta pay money for that?
You gotta pay money for that.
You gotta pay to see these titties, right, man.
Or chitlins.
These chitlins, man.
These chitlins.
These are some special chitlins right here.
how much does it cost to get a Fumigado spitting some rhymes? How much do I have to pay you?
A 12-pack of Modelos.
12-pack of Modelos? All right, I got you. Go ahead. Spit a rhyme.
You walked into that one, dude. Do it.
Oh, you don't spit it out?
No, I don't. I'm fucking retarded right now.
What the f- We just smoked a blunt.
I'm just trying to stay alive.
You see,
right now.
This right here is some finger hash. It was a little bit fatter, but we broke off like a chunk.
Packy loves to show off weed. I've noticed this about Packy Chan.
I do. What the fuck? My name says it all. You're like Packy Chan. I thought you
never,
fucking knew
I've
this.
Never met anybody.
You're like
that
a little girl
weed off
with her brand new Barbie.
Dear Diary.
That's a new segment that's coming up. It's called Dear Diary.
Yeah, my boy right here, Fumigado, is going to be narrating a new segment called Dear Diary.
Dear Diary.
So, do you have anything to say about what you write in your diary?
Do I have anything to say?
Yeah. Anything you, have you
added? All about you.
It's all about Peggy.
All
about Packy Chan. Hell yeah, I'm down with that.
And his infamous diary. This fool leaves it everywhere.
You leave it everywhere?
I know, I do.
Everywhere.
I'll be on the bus and shit, writing a verse or something. Sometimes I forget on the bus, but I'm always leaving shit at his house or at B-Side's house. Yeah. It could be my keys, my hat, my sweater, my bud, my wax.
Really?
I left like about a gram and a half of wax at his house that he hasn't even fucking looked for yet. But I know it's there.
It's not there. It's
gone, gone, dude.
It's gone.
Hey, I blame Rocket. Rocket probably ate it.
Fucking.
He likes to eat weed. That's.
Who's Rocky, your son?
No.
Rocky.
Brian's son.
Brian's little
baby boy.
B-Side's son. That's your son.
That motherfucker never wants to shut the fuck up.
He fucking. I think, honestly, I think your dog has short-term memory, dude. I'm telling you.
Yeah, 10-second rocket.
Yeah,
10-second
rocket.
Blind, it's a 10-second rocket, man.
The only reason he don't bark like a Bunet or at Yves because they have that perfume smell. So, I know this smell.
They smell nice.
So, he can't see shit.
So, what the fuck do you smell like, man?
I fucking smell like shit.
Every time Rocket sees this guy?
Yeah.
It's like the end of the world right there.
He don't stop barking
at him. He hates you?
Evil.
He hates Asian.
Yeah, he senses his evil.
I think there's like a demon surrounding me or something.
He thinks you're going to eat him because you're Asian, fool. Yeah.
The fucking fur on the back of his head stands up and shit.
Oh, my God.
And apparently Rocket doesn't like my dancing.
Oh, really?
He hates. He was spinning. Like, B-side was spinning and I was just feeling, you know, the groove, and as soon as I started dancing, I was like, oh shit,
Pack is not a very good dancer.
I'm not a good dancer, but come on, man.
You suck apparently. Yeah,
I know that, but apparently like suck to the point where this one wants to attack me.
Yeah,
like, fuck you, fucking white guys dancing. That's still the
homie. He was barking at you. You said your white guy's dancing and your dick is small. That's what you said. That's fucked up.
I'm a kill Rocket for saying that.
That's fucked up. That's what my dog used to tell me. He used to look at me. I'd be like, I know you're telling me my dick is small, but fuck you, dog. You don't know me. I'm a grower, not a shower.
I'm a grower.
It's the motion of the ocean.
Fuck that dog.
I know, man. My favorite part about that dog, though, is if you get up and go get a beer and come back, it's the end of the world for you again.
Why?
Because he forgets who you are.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, like, we'll be sitting
down. I love you, Rocket.
We'll be sitting down, just chilling, having a beer. Hey, anybody want a beer? Sure. One of us will go in and go, damn, I left for like 5 seconds, fool.
Fuck that dog.
I was right there.
Why you guys have this dog? Like, what? Why do you guys attach to this dog so much?
It's Brian's. B-Side's son.
This is my dog.
It's really your dog?
Yeah, this is B-Side's dog.
Aw, man, why is your dog so mean?
Well, he's a rescue.
He's a rescue. Yeah. I think that's part of the...
Yeah, he probably traumatized. Somebody fucked with him bad and shit. So
he's part of the Crip gang, actually. That's where I rescued him from.
For reals?
He went on drive-bys.
How'd you know? Was it tatted? Like, did it have tats?
He threw up the C's, dude.
He threw up the C's. How'd you know he was Crip gang?
I found him on
He had a bandana on.
He did have the bandana on.
He had the three dots on his hat.
The jumpsuit. Like Tupac, that pink, the orange jumpsuit.
That's crazy. So, Bisa, what's it like having a dog with so much street cred?
No shit, dude. You know,
Bisa feels safe walking in any hood. Now.
I don't actually. This dog's done a lot of dirt. You know what I'm saying? So, it's kind of crazy.
He's not in his hood anymore.
So,
you think he's gonna come back to get you? Like, somebody's gonna come after the dog and get you in the process? Like,
I'm serious because I see dogs that look like him that were from his hood. I'm like, oh shit, that could be his cousin.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying. So
he's gonna have a drive by for you. Caught up in the crossfire.
Oh man, that shit's funny. But
hey, lucky dogs don't have thumbs, dude.
But you know what's funny is that so B-Side's girl has another dog, pretty dope dog. His name's Maki.
Okay,
Maki.
Whenever he comes over, that fool is very lovable. He'll come and play with me. He'll remember me. But as soon as I start playing with him, his dog starts going crazy and getting jealous. And that's when he starts like giving me attention.
Yeah.
Oh, motherfuckers, you're not getting all the attention. Now you want my attention. Fucking whore.
Fucking whore.
Yeah. Fuck that puto.
I don't appreciate you calling my dogs whores, first of all.
Well, Maki's not a whore. Maki's the homie, dude. Fuck Rocket.
Rocket doesn't like you, man. Yeah, he doesn't like you at all.
He does not give a fuck.
He sees you like a stranger.
I know.
Like, who the fuck are you?
I'm telling you, he has short-term memory. Yeah.
So did you guys want to do hip-hop news? Or you guys
Packy has no sense of time, so let's just...
Enough about Rocket.
All right,
but remember, we did have our shit crash for like about 20 minutes.
Yeah,
man.
20 minutes.
All right,
so fuck you, B-Side.
All right, here we go. Go ahead, handle your news.
All right, B-Side, you said you wanted to talk about this.
No, I didn't. No, I didn't.
You were the one explaining it to me, dude. Because all my notes, I left my notes at home
for the second week in a row.
Yes.
Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah. At least I admit my mistake.
It's classic Packy, though.
This is the Packy Chan show.
Anybody that knows this fool.
President Donald Trump has historically low approval ratings as he nears 100-day mark.
Yeah. But you know he's doing a bunch of shit trying to get in and under the wire. You know he's trying to change healthcare right now. He got the Freedom Caucus's approval, mm-hmm. which is scary. They might actually do it now. And he's trying. He's having a meeting today with all the senators about North Korea, trying to convince them to go in it with them. He's trying to. He's first going to try to get permission from Congress, but if he can't, then he's going to do what he can to do what he can because he's a child.
To go to war?
Yeah.
Ooh. Ooh.
North
with
Korea.
North Korea with Syria. Yep.
Ooh, and man. North Korea has made. Well, this is all stuff that we've been told. I don't have people there. I'm not on the ground. I'm no. You know, I'm just hearing stuff that you hear. But the thing is, North Korea is saying, hey, we don't want no beef, but if you come after us, we're going to have to come after you because we're not going to be wiped out without trying.
They want somebody to fuck with them. They're playing games, and Trump is falling right into their trap and shit. It's going to be some crazy-ass shit because they do have the nuclear capability.
Yeah.
You know, they have been testing rockets and shit that keeps but going farther and farther.
But do they have the nuclear capability? Are you sure?
Yeah.
Who, well, North Korea?
Yeah.
Don't you think?
No, they don't.
You don't think that they have the nuclear capability?
I don't think so. Not yet, anyway. But it's only a matter of time before the whole world does. You know what I mean? And then what? You know? Fuck.
Chaos. Nuclear war everywhere, man.
We're just going to cease to exist.
Fuck that. Because
this planet's going to be inhabitable, but whatever.
And Hannibal, like Hannibal, telling Cannibal. Bill Cosby jokes and then getting in trouble.
Hell yeah.
See, where's that article with Lil Yachty?
Lil Yachty,
Yachty fans, so say what's up.
So let me tell you, Bill Clinton told me, well, fucking Lil Yachty doesn't even have a Lil Yachty.
No, he has a little tugboat.
Tugboat. That's what I heard. If he has a kayak, he has a pontoon boat. That's what I heard.
So there was I guess
El Fumigado.
Some shit going on what's going on
online. Tell us what are they telling us.
It actually kicked me off right now. So
really,
yeah.
Let me check. See, make sure it's still on.
So, and then I'm checking my text messages.
Oh yeah, your fucking channel keeps crashing on here, dude.
My channel. Well, then stop going live on there. Then we'll just stick to the YouTube.
And what were you saying? What else are you saying?
Just checking my text messages.
Oh, it kicked you off your text messages?
Well, no. After it kicked me off, I'm just checking my text messages.
All right, Packy.
But
all right. So, if there's any Lil Yachty fans, I hate you.
Yeah.
So there's this shit going on between Lil Yachty and Joe Budden.
Joe Biden.
Joe Biden.
Oh, no, Budden.
I call him Budden, not Joe Biden.
Oh, it is Budden. You're right.
Damn it. Where's that video? Let me see. I'm going to play this video about
Lil Yachty.
Yeah.
Bad for hip-hop culture.
This is Joe Budden's point of view about Lil Yachty.
How old is Joe Budden, by the way? Let's get that.
It's like 50-something, no?
I think he's 84.
I was thinking like 90.
He's kind of old, though.
No, but yeah. It's not the same. It's Biden and Budden are two dudes.
Oh, hold up. Wrong, hold up.
Biden and Budden. Budden, Biden.
Yeah, Joe Biden. This dude. Dope MC.
What's up with
Joe Biden?
Hold on.
Firefox has prevented.
Allow now. Yeah. Allow. Continue allowing. Fucking. What is it doing?
Damn you. Damn you. Damn you, Daniel. See, your cable company is fucking
they're
with your shit.
You.
That way you can.
They don't like your message,
so you can get the higher grade. They're fucking with you, dude.
Yeah, for reals. I don't know. Your video doesn't want to load. I should have downloaded it. All right. I know my.
We should do the segment with Dear Diary. In the meanwhile.
Come on.
What's your diary?
This is
diary.
A segment. Let me plug the segment real quick.
Okay, so let B-Side explain it.
So this is Packy's inner child writing in his diary.
I want to push the button. It's not your turn to push the button.
And
I want to push the button.
Narrated by El Fumigado.
Oh, okay. This is go crazy.
So every time he would forget his diary, like at his place or my place.
Yeah.
I always go, Dear Diary, today I got my period. It wasn't fun. I was not expecting that.
What else? That's it. Boo. I don't like the diary today.
I bust my first rhyme. It was so dope. I felt fresh. So fresh. I think I'm going to be an MC. Bye for now. Toodaloo.
Oh my god.
What about you, B-side? Come on, B-side. Oh, give us a page.
Brian
give
is
us a page.
Evil. Brian is evil.
Give us a page, B-side.
Brian gets nasty sometimes.
Hey, did you know that B-side modeled for trophies?
Model for trophies.
Oh, come on, dude. That's like third grade shit right there.
is that what you did in your spare time?
I did, though.
Oh, shit.
That's shit.
Like, that's a funny part. Yeah. I did it in third grade.
You're a fucking model?
That's when I did it in third grade.
Wow. I got a rapper as a friend, a model as a friend.
Yeah. Oh, shit. This video is not going to play, bro. I'm gonna download it.
Download that shit.
Yeah. All right.
So, while we're doing that, B-Side's going to do a quick segment. And by the way, everything today is just freestyle.
Pop the Trunk Production.
There's a lot of notes that we're missing.
Pop the Trunk Production.
Shout out to Bernie Sanders listening out there.
I love you, Bernie.
Bernie? All
right.
Bernie's the homie.
That's right.
We're about to smoke some more weed with some more hash in it.
We got some funny Bible quotes coming up.
Oh, no.
I've got you now, Susie. Come on, I'm only playing. Don't struggle. I'm bigger and stronger than you.
I don't understand. No more tray.
Solve them.
Hello?
Hello?
What up?
What's up, man?
Who's this?
This is Dre Day All Day and Packy Chan.
Ooh, Dre Day All Day, All Day.
What happened, Mr. Ipkiss? Ipkiss was supposed to be here.
Sorry about that, man. Weekday type shit.
Damn, man, we just had some like some ill freestyle that it just completely crashed the system for a bit, man.
We had such a hot freestyle, it crashed the whole entire system. Packy broke the internet. Yeah, it was
dude,
me.
That shit just crashed completely. That your shit's too hot, man. Overload.
I was watching the show and it kept getting like y'all still getting kicked out.
Yeah, oh, you can watch the show but can't come to the show, huh, motherfucker?
We're live on YouTube right now. Or download the Super Audio Network app from the Android market. Yep, you'll be able to watch it.
Hey man, we gotta get you over here on the show, man. UN fix. So we can talk about the hot box on the show.
Yeah man, let's get us going next week, man. I'll try not to miss it this that time.
Ah shit, hope not, dog, cause now I'm 100 ass down.
Oh shit.
I've been known to kidnap one or two people.
Yeah. This is not my first time hiding a body. I'm just playing.
Dre's gonna throw you in the black box.
In the boo box.
Alright.
Alright, Mr.
How was your show? How was your show on Saturday?
It was cool, man. It had lots of fun.
It was tight.
Yeah, man. I got blessed with plenty of presents, man. It was beautiful.
That's tight, brother. Have a belated birthday, bro.
Oh, for sure. So next time when you come in, we're gonna play a whole new different shock, paper, scissors game.
Alright.
Courtesy of Dre.
Oh, fuck. I don't wanna get shocked, bro.
All right, Mr. Ipkiss, we'll catch you later.
All right, brothers, take it easy, man. Thanks again. Peace. So let's get our heads together. Let's form a bad weather for claimers and perpetrators. Well said, alligator. All realm, no perpetrator. Let society choose the elevator of success by identity crossbreeder. Complex thinking, they're really much greater. Playing raw, honest, or maybe rough raider. Tough enough to perpetrate, I'll talk to you later. But wait, what about the midget brains? Unable to see reality too unreal. I'm sealed with mind, body, and soul connected together. We're tougher than leather. We're much more than you think we are. We are the product of our own environment. Repent with equality plus duality. And taking all kind of possibilities, abilities. I sing the song from the soul. Let it rise from the tone. Let it rhythmically grow into its own life. Let it become you. Then you become it. Once you become it, everything will be infinite. Will be infinite. Will be infinite. We're much more than you think we are. We are the product of our own.
Time filled with rhymes, we force minds to climb way up above all that bullshit you love, keeping your soul intact with the rap. It's underworld 96 fat. In a time filled with rhymes, we force minds to climb way up above all that bullshit you love, keeping your soul intact with the rap. It's underworld 96 fat. They couldn't see me, so I entered right before their eyes, past the people dancing to the cuts where I reside. Spied the tightest girl, but I knew she'd never notice. A man on stage grabs the mic, so I took my focus. Oh, this is a show, it kinda sucks. Kinda fuck my purpose, it's hate. It's worthless, a circus full of circles. Three rings of jerks, fool, tell them that the weak come. Boss one, please speak. I'm seeking out the beat, but all I find is imitation. Rhyme assimilation, and times I'm in for wasting. Racing around the club, searching for some type of meaning. Receiving shit as real is the only one it's seeming. Though feeding for the hip hop, cause I love this shit to death. And until the day I die, keep it honest in the West. Not astonished nor impressed by developments and letdowns. Expect the unexpected, never would I set bounds. I sweat clowns, the sounds that aren't fresh though. The end of world is here, so motherfuck where the rest go. In a time filled with rhymes, we force minds to climb way up above all that bullshit you love, keeping your soul intact with the rap. It's underworld 96 fat. In a time filled with rhymes, we force minds to climb way up above all that bullshit you love, keeping your soul intact with the rap. It's underworld 96 fat. Stay up late writing, entice when the beat hits. it's the when. Thoughts go through my mind like, boy, my life is fun. From the sun up to down, the sounds I imagine. One day I get it right, and in this period of lag and dragging on like my dreams in my cape, there's so much impact I could make if I could only bear the weight. Don't fear the grave, hubby, and study how it is. This hella shit be taking, yet hella left to give. I look my life, but it's mine, so it's hard to find my place. The look of determination, and I can
Yeah, that was DJ B-Side. DJ B-Side. I say DJ B-Side.
Does DJ mean disc jockey?
This guy.
This jock?
Disc jock.
How about DJ stands for disjoint?
Dumb joints. Danky joints. DJ stands for danky joints.
What does DJ stand for?
Ask Mr.
Anybody know?
It's disc jockey.
Disc jockey.
Disc jockey. See, now, see, you learn things here at the Packet Challenge show for me, Gado.
Right.
Damn, dude, this is an educated segment, dude.
I love this part of my life.
I thought it stand for Dark Jesus.
That's what it should be.
Yep. Oh, man. That shit was funny.
Hey, so.
How much more we got time we got left?
No, that's it. I just pushed the clock back, but now we got segment. What's going on with segment?
Shit, I don't know, man. We just had our segment. We had everything.
We had Dear Diary.
We had Dear Diary. We had the news. We had the birthdays.
Well, I think what we were going to talk about was play to play, but...
Yeah, I wanted to talk about that when we have other MCs who dealt with that. There's no other MCs besides me.
Yeah.
Have you ever paid to play before, Mr. B-Side?
That's foreign to me. I'm a DJ. They pay me.
Exactly.
They need to pay me.
This is that's a topic that I want to save for when we have another MC. That was the whole point of Mr. Ipkiss coming in.
Well, I mean,
I've done a bunch of I've done a few shows myself, and I've never paid to play. And I wouldn't respect any guy who asked me to pay to play. I mean, if anything, I mean, I've had people ask me to sell tickets, but even that's like, I'm like, nah, I'm not really into that shit.
See, I've done that. I haven't. I mean, technically, it is pay to play because you have to sell tickets.
Yeah, but it's just at least you know it's less grimy. Where I'm like, yo, give me $50 and you can perform. Yeah, at least yeah. I'm selling tickets and you know I'm getting people to come in, like getting heads in. You know, mm-hmm. What do you think?
Like, okay, so for people who are beginning,
I don't think we're good enough to have this conversation.
No, we're not. Yeah. No. I'll just ask you for a quick. Yeah.
See, that's what I'm saying. Like, we need other artists. No,
yeah,
he's
agreeing with me. Fuck.
No, I want to prove my point, motherfucker.
What's
shit.
What's your point, Packy? I'm curious about your point now.
No, now you're going to have to wait for next week.
Why?
All right.
Because. That's
go ahead, Packy.
Damn, if we got it, I'm sorry, dog. This fucking, we started late. The shit broke down. Shit's not working. We're not getting Facebook going. I'm sorry, dog. It's not always like this.
I guess I've seen a lot of people try to make a case for play to play as far as you're making an investment in yourself, you know, because if you have your shit together and you know your shit's tight, you have a product, you know, and you're gonna open for fucking so and so that's dope right now, like Lil Yachty or some bullshit, I don't know.
Yeah, but there's that was a question that I asked on my Facebook, and the best answer was by I clicked the super line, you know what I mean? And he basically broke it down, like if he was to book his son for a pay to play, he had to make sure that it was worth it, and it wasn't just a promoter who was about just getting the money.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And it's hard to find promoters to do that shit.
Yeah.
Well, like, who isn't for the money though?
Like for me, for example, okay. Yeah, I'm a promoter. Of course, I want to make money when I do a show. But me personally, I can't pay the artist out of my pocket. You know, a big chunk of that money goes for the DJ, the main act, and stuff like that. So
what
I tell them, look, whatever people you bring to the show, I will give you 50% out of every person that pays to see you. So if the show is $10, $5 for you, $5 for me.
Yeah.
That should motivate them. Okay, that's how you get paid. Because I can't pay you out of my pocket.
Yeah.
you know?
Yeah, but at the same time, these dudes don't want to do that. You know what I mean? Because it's still the same proposition that other people were giving them. They got to sell tickets.
I'm not saying, in order for you to perform, you have to sell tickets. I'm not asking them to sell tickets. They could still perform. It doesn't matter to me. But if you want to make money, when they come to the door, just say, yeah, I'm here to see so-and-so. All right, cool. This artist brought this person to the show and paid $10 to come and see him. He deserves that $5.
God.
Yeah, yeah, it sounds like a good thing, like, on paper, that. But if the headliner is not worth $10, then you're
Of course. Yeah. Like, it breaks it down to what Click the Superland said. You got to make sure it's worth it. It's a dope headliner. There's not like 15, 20 acts performing in the same show. Because I've seen shit, dude, like a while back, somebody said, hey, who wants to perform in this tour, in this festival for free? But in the clause, it says, in order for you to be part of this,
yeah,
you have to pay at the door to get into the show you're performing. What the fuck? And you have to buy a minimum two drinks. So you're still paying to perform.
Yeah.
That just feels weird.
It does.
That's fucked up shit.
What the hell?
They're like, what the fuck? And then you got those people that'll say, okay, we'll let you perform, but you sell this many tickets and only give you like 5-10 minutes. I've done shows where we've got booked. We didn't sell tickets, but we got booked and they only gave us like one song.
What the fuck?
Yeah, because they had like 15 acts downstairs and 15 acts upstairs.
Hell no, that's what I'm saying, dude.
If you have a well organized show with a good headliner, not that many acts, then you're good, you know?
Yeah.
But now, because of this system, we've generated a whole generation of MCs that are accustomed to doing 10-minute sets. You know what I mean? Because of all this squeezing people in a show. You know what I mean? And
everybody's expecting, okay, you start at, say, 10 o'clock. Your set ends at 10:15. And they expect the next act to go on at 10:15.
Yeah, that's what I don't like.
What the fuck? And then, you
got to give people time to get to class.
Yeah, so it's like, come on, dude. There's always got to be a little at least a 5-minute gap between artists. You know, that gives the host to do the chance to do their thing, keep the crowd entertained while the next act gets ready to go on.
Yeah.
You know? So there's a lot to it. If it's worth it, it's worth it. Yeah,
But we'll get more into that next week, right? When we have more MCs here, more artists. El Fumigado is going to come back, right?
I'll come back.
Hell yeah.
You going to come back? Are you going to come back as El Fumigado, or are you going to come back as Caitlyn Jenner?
He's going to come back as Caitlyn.
And Caitlyn Jenner.
Don't judge me.
I've gone to his house and I caught him looking like
Packing not to Jenner. Tell nobody.
I tell everybody I'm sorry. I tell everybody.
Damn you.
But yeah, man, that's something that would have been dope to talk more about if we had other MCs who had that experience.
If we did.
I mean, so...
What do we have any MCs out there that want to comment on the situation?
Are we live on Facebook?
We're not live on Facebook.
Oh, we're not live.
We're live on YouTube, and I'll fix the Facebook thing by the next time. Yeah. It's been giving me a lot of problems. I don't know. Everything was fine. When it first came out, everything was fine. Everything was smooth. And then all of a sudden, they start implementing this time limit where you can only, have video or go live. I haven't figured that out. I haven't bothered. And then all of a sudden, they started making you write descriptions and shit. And now it's asking me to authorize and test bandwidth and all kinds of other shit. So I don't know what's going on Facebook, but they seem to not want you to go live on their system through other programs. You know what I mean?
Wow. What about through his like page, maybe? Would it be easier to do like the stream key or whatever?
You can go live from your phone, fine. Like, your phone, if you want to use your phone, you can go live, fine. But whenever I try to use XSplit, it's fucking giving me problems. But I'm going to figure it out. I'm a fucking champion.
I believe in you, Dre.
Yeah,
I believe in you.
Geek Squad ain't got shit on me.
You're gonna get Mr. Robot on it.
This is Nerd Squad. This is Nerd Team.
Are you gonna be like Matt Damon and science the shit out of this?
I'm gonna fucking MacGyver this shit.
Hell yeah, I like the MacGyver one better.
I'm gonna inspect the gadget, this motherfucker. Go gadget, internet.
Hey man, you are one crazy ass motherfucker. Shit.
Don't tell nobody, man.
Big fat secret.
I got a job. I got shit I got to do, like serious shit, like real stuff.
Hey, so when is the video game Olympics?
The video game Olympics is coming to you in June.
So
we're gonna have 10 games, about 6 systems, over 4 genres, and it's gonna be crazy shit. I'm going to have it streamlined this time. I'm not going to have everybody playing one game at a time, and then I'm going to have multiple games going on at once. There's going to be refs going around. We're going to have a simple point system, and somebody's going to walk away with a prize.
What's the prize?
I don't know. Probably something Bluetooth. Actually, the first prize. All right, so last year I gave him a trophy. This year I'm making a trophy out of Legos, and I'm putting one of those retro pies in there, so you'll be able to plug it to your TV and play all the video games.
Oh, what?
Yeah.
That's tight. What? See?
Yeah.
If you guys want to join, then let them know.
And then second place and third place.
What game is it? The slots full already?
Nah, I think I still have two slots left.
What game is it?
A bunch of different games.
You're not releasing the game titles?
Not yet, but I will soon. I will soon because I want to give people a chance to
like NBA
to, like, try
shit.
If it's NBA, probably NBA Jam. I try to go arcade or simple. It's gonna be
Ninja Turtles.
I'm gonna try to do one, you know, Super Nintendo, one Sega, a couple of Xbox 360s, a couple of arcades.
Super Mario's brother.
At least a Wii.
Dude, go Mario Kart. Do Mario
Kart. Mario
Kart
sounds fun.
I want to play Mario Kart. I'm in the competition, so. I want to play Mario Kart and shit.
Yeah, that might be a good Super Nintendo title, Super Mario Kart.
Hell yeah.
I can't do 64 because my emulator sucks and I can't get nobody to give me a fucking system. If anybody has a Nintendo 64 system that they do not want, I will buy it off you, but not for more than $30. Everyone wants to charge me a shitload. And I'm like,
retro, man. It's vintage.
And what sucks is I can play all the other 64 games, but Mario Kart has problems when you get to two player.
Ooh.
They can't emulate it right.
It crashes?
It just can't be emulated right.
And when's Freestyle Fridays?
Freestyle Friday is Cinco de Mayo. Is our first comeback. Our series back premiere. And we've been gone for a while, like for months. But we're coming back hard and strong with two episodes next month in May. Cinco de Mayo and May 9th, I think it is. I'm cool. I'm fucking done.
Hey, and man, these guys can't hang, dude. We rolled like three blunts.
You're a maniac.
With a gang up, a finger hash.
You're a maniac, Mr. Peggy
Chan.
That's
how we do it, the Peggy Chan show.
And when he says
we
hash.
We haven't even smoked the wax yet.
What the fuck?
And then it's going to be comeback. We got a new co-host. B-Pack is going to help me co-host from now on. Or he's going to try to. And we're going to reformat the show. We're going to try, like, we're not going to, you know what I mean? We're going to try to make it simpler for the people competing, but also fun for the people watching.
Okay.
And yeah, somebody's gonna win a prize on that show too.
Hell yeah, and I'm part of that one too.
Yeah, you're coming up on Cinco de Mayo, right?
Yep.
You a space.
It's gonna be
Packy Chan.
I need my cheerleader there to cheer me on, B-Side and Jacob.
I'm busy that day. Sorry.
You look so
cute
in the
B-Side in here.
Actually, you know what, Cinco de Mayo, that's a big day.
That's Drinko de Mayo.
I know. That's why I'm doing it early, 6:30.
I say everyone, every loser has to chug like three beers.
Oh, that's crazy. I'm down for a beer. I will get a 12 pack.
Ah, nice.
Yeah.
Whoever loses has to shotgun a beer.
And then
take a shot.
It's still gonna be four rounds. It's still gonna be a Royal Rumble, Royal Humble at the end. And
I like that shit. Explain that.
There's four rounds in the Freestyle Friday, and you know there's points and whatever, blah blah blah. Think of UFC, but the point is that the last round is Royal Rumble, right? So yeah. You have MCs and they can battle each other. No matter who, you guys could double team somebody. You could take on two, whatever fuck ladder match, whatever fuck you want. And then the second part is the Royal Humble, where you could battle each other, but you can only say nice things about your opponent. So, you know, and then somebody found a loophole where they were like, well, I didn't want to say nice, nothing nice about nobody. So he started talking shit about himself.
I was there, I think.
I was like, that counts, fool. Damn, you found a loophole.
Yeah.
So
it's pretty cool, man.
It's pretty cool. What do you think about that, fool? What do you think about that?
That's fucking hilarious.
Hilarious?
Yes.
You don't sound amazed.
Well,
I expect you to jump up in your...
I'm retardedly.
Retardedly high?
No, for me, I said be smoking that thing. Come on, man.
Hey, how old do you think he was when he started smoking weed?
22.
Guess again.
2 years old.
2 years old. Straight out of the womb, homie.
Yep.
Yeah.
I walked out that.
He's a late bloomer, dude. He just starts at like 30 what?
30.
35?
30.
You
wait till it was legal?
Yeah.
And then you smoked it?
This was 45.
How old were you when you started smoking?
16.
And B-side?
I was 19 years old.
How old were you?
11. My 11th birthday.
Really?
My brother got me out.
That was your present? Happy birthday.
Yeah.
That's fucking hilarious.
He's a late bloomer, dude. He never smoked stress, dude. Never.
Oh, really? Well, actually, I did.
You did?
Yeah. When
you
I could,
lied, you
when
lied
I,
to me.
When I couldn't get some good stuff, I was like, well, we can go to
my connect.
I'm so stupid
right now.
But I only did it a few times, and from there on, I said never again.
That's it, everybody. We are coming down to the end of our show.
Alright.
Do you want to shout out anybody, Mr. Fumigado? No? Any of your cheerleader friends? No? Shout out. No shout out to your favorite cousin, George Marquez?
Oh, yeah, huh? George Marquez.
George Marquez was watching for a little bit.
He's a big supporter.
He's one of our biggest supporters, too, who stays on from beginning to end.
Yeah. I promise next time to have this on YouTube, on Facebook.
Dre's on the job.
Yeah.
This is like a hidden episode now.
Yeah.
This episode's worth a lot of money.
Yeah.
I like it.
So if you find it, cash in, everybody.
Good luck, right?
There we go. We are coming to the end. Like I said, my name is Peggy Chin, motherfuckers. And who do I have with me today? Say your name.
DA B-Side.
DJ B-Side.
Say your DA.
And we got El Fumigado right here.
El Fumigado.
He's like so stupid high that he can't talk.
He doesn't know his name right now.
Yeah, he thinks he's still inside the womb.
Yeah. He's in the fetal position.
He's right now in the corner crying, yelling, mommy, mommy, mommy.
No more locked doors. No more hash.
You know what's funny is I had a homie eat a whole eighth of shrooms.
God.
And then he was in the corner of the room asking for his mommy, like, yeah, you just did it.
No way.
Yeah. And then I eventually left because I was freaking out too because I was on shrooms too. But I found out later he pissed himself.
Oh, what my the God. Fuck?
Yeah.
Hey, what's the, like the worst trip you had on mushrooms?
Oh, that's a story for another day.
All right, so in that case, next Wednesday we're gonna have our worst mushroom trips as a topic.
I like that topic.
I've only had dope ones though.
Really?
Well,
I've never had a bad one. I had a bad like 30 minutes and that was it.
Exactly. Like you recover, but it's still kind of freaky. Like you freak out.
Yeah.
I can tell you about my worst shroom trip.
What was your worst shroom trip?
Dude, anytime I smoked it, that shit made me feel like I was underwater.
Like fuck, drowning?
Dude. Yeah.
Did you feel at points where you thought you were going fast, but you were really going slow?
Nah, I felt like I was, like, everything was far away. Like, I just kept remembering, looking at a building, and I kept telling my homie, like, that window is so far away. And he's like, yeah, fool, whatever. Like, I don't give a fuck. You're high.
What was your favorite drug as a kid? As a teenager?
All of them.
All of them?
Trying them out.
His favorite was cocaine.
I hate that stuff. It gets me
cocaine. I reckon someone called my name.
Cocaine. All right, y'all.
Just kidding.
We're coming.
Just kidding,
the
mom.
End. Peace out. Peggy Chain here. Dre Day. B-Side. Fumigado. See you next week. This is the hidden gem. Make sure you find it.
Hidden episode.
Money.
Yes.
Find it on Netflix.
You can trade it for hookers.
For hookers.
Specto.
All right.
Peace.
Peace.
Peace out.